Hey everybody, and welcome back to another episode of Serious Creeps Adventures in Minecraft. And I know it's been a few days since I uploaded my last episode, but that's because I didn't have my microphone for a few days. But I've got it back, so I can record again. And if you wonder what I'm doing here and what this stuff is, I'm actually gonna work on the destination selector thingy majiggy today. So I tried out a few things and how I want to build it, and I think this is something I'm gonna aim for. Okay, let me try to explain. So as you can see, I have a minecart track here. This is gonna be our departure zone. So you come down here with a minecart, and right now you can see this curve leads to this bed. Let's call it the bed station. If you want to go this way though, the, let's say, window station, you would have to modify this track. So this one is hooked up to a RS knowledge here. And if I give this power, it will switch and stay switched. And this minecart turns around, minecart track turns around. So in this case, my minecart will just keep going and then go this way. If you want to go even further, you will have to activate this one as well. So both are on right now, and you will just keep going forward to your death or something. And you can also reset this again. If you power this up here, it will just move power forward and reset everything, so everything is back. You can't just activate this one, otherwise it will turn back. So you always have to do both, and then you can remove it. So that works. This thing here in this corner is actually just a smaller version of the RS knowledge. I think it's smaller. So in this case, you have like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Do I need this one? Yeah, I think 5 blocks. And here we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 as well, actually. Okay, never mind. It's the same length, I guess. But I like this one more because I don't need those weird blocks here. They look sort of weird, so I'm gonna go with this one, I guess. In order to activate those things, even though they are spaced 2 blocks away, or well, one in between, but every second block is a wire, I could add a stone and then add a button here and add a button here for the 2 wires and leave this blank. But I want to use all of those stones. So to do this, I will have a wall of stone with buttons, and I'm just gonna take use of the redstone, or how far redstone can travel. If you power a wire, you could travel 15 blocks with it. So starting out, this one's like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. So the next one would not be powered anymore. So I'm gonna use this, because right now, as you can see, this one isn't powered either. These 3 are on. If I move this 1 forward instead of 2, this one would be on. So they're actually next to each other, so I can use that to distinguish between those cables here. I can just move this one over here and the second one to over there. It just gives me an advantage of here, so I don't have to space out things a lot. If I move further away, as you can see, this one is off, but these 2 are on. And if I even go to the end, only this one is on. So I'm going to use this for my minecart station. And I prepared a few things down here. Not too much. I have to be careful here with creepers. And I still have to build a wall or something next to my minecart stuff so they don't get pushed. And yes, I switched back to Svex PUBD texture pack because you guys seem to like it a lot more, so I'm gonna stick with it. So this is gonna be the wall with my buttons. I'm gonna have, I think, 6 buttons. Well, 7. This one is gonna be to reset everything, but technically we can have 7 stations here. That should be enough. So behind this, oh, whoa, what happened there? That was weird. I fell through the redstone block and sort of, ah, I can't place it here. Sort of drifted down here. Very strange. But yeah, as you can see, this one, this cable here is going to be to reset my track. This just goes down here and then up again and this way. And this one here is for the other six stations. So I have to move it at least from, let's see, from this point on 15 blocks forward, which is going to be here. And then starting from here, I'm going to build those repeater things that you saw at my house going this way, I think. It's going to be a bit tricky to build because we don't have a lot of space here, as you can see. And this is the mountain and here's the station. So I have to organize things a bit here. So I'm thinking about going down this way and then probably turn right. Does that work? Actually, no, that's not going to work. Because they get longer and longer the further I go. So the longest one would be here. And I can't go over here without cutting those off. So that's not going to work. I have to go this way. So how many blocks do we have here? Also, if I go this way, the track is going to be behind this wall here. It's going to be here. So we would probably go this way to leave the minecart station. It's going to be a bit weird, but I hope it's working. It's going to work out. And to help me here, I brought some tools. Ha ha ha, TNT. Figured we haven't really used it much yet, so I'm going to use it now. And I always forget how you space them. I don't know if I have to place the next one here or here. Well, we will figure it out. I think I'm going to place it here just in case. And cover this with stone. And then the next one will be here. Let's try this. Oh boy, I'm going to start here. Oh wait, that doesn't work. Workbench, I'm gonna make it a lever. That should work better than this. Alright, here we go. Let's see if that works. Beautiful! That's perfect. That's how I wanted it. Nice clean cut, except for here because there was dirt, but whatsoever. We can fix that. And that's pretty nice. Also, my pickaxe is sort of almost gone, and I used my fortune one to gather more stuff. Got a few more diamonds, but nothing really impressive, so I should be fine for now. We have like, I don't know, a bit over one stack of diamonds, so that's pretty good. We don't really need more than that. That's a weird hole here. Oh, this goes actually into my base, right. This was where the glowstone was. Okay, so need to figure things out here now, how to do it. Alright, so I placed on these repeater things here, and actually I think I'm one too close. We can try this pretty easy. Oh man, I should really close this stuff off. If this one is on, nothing happens because I placed it wrong. Which one is activated? Is this one on? Okay, this one is on, so that means we actually need one more here. No, wait. Yeah, this is fine. Okay, so if this lever is on, the first one here, this one should be powered, and if nothing is on, yeah, obviously we would go the first track. Okay, so there's gonna be two tracks. All right, so this is okay. And now the tricky part. I'm gonna actually go this way from here on, and they need to be set on a specific delay, but I don't know which one yet. So it depends on how I set up my other track thing. So we can do this later. But from here on, we go one in and then we build our clock here, which I already almost forgot how to build. I think I'm gonna go do the fast one. All right, this is correct. Just had to double check. So this is our clock. And then we can just do the other ones. So we need 6. So 2, 3, 4. And we need to go this way a bit more. TNT time. Do we have more levels? Level? Not really. Here, I guess. So, let's make another one. Didn't even actually have to create the workbench before. Only 2 slots. Oops. That could have been dangerous, so. Boom! I love it. I should use TNT more often. And I guess we can do the same here, even though this is dirt, so I might destroy something next to it, but we will see. No risk, no fun. Yeah, that went a bit too far. Oh well, that's okay. At least we have enough room now to finish this stuff here. So 6 over here, and then the 7 track would be here, the last one, if nothing is if everything is on. Which probably is gonna be we'll probably go back into the arrival zone just to have a fallback in case no station is selected or something. So let me finish the things completely here and then we keep going. Alright, finish the thing up, I think, if I didn't miss anything, and I also get some more resources because we will need it. So the next thing I need to do is add a bridge in between, which we will use to reset everything. And all we do here is just put a repeat on top. And I think they also need a specific delay, but I have to double check. I built everything in my test world before, so I can just check how things work there. So it's not going to be too bad. And is this correct? Should be. Sorry for all the cuts. I had to double check again if this was correct. I just want to make sure I don't mess this up here. But it seems to be good. So the next one is going to be this here. Going to do like this. Guess I can just extend all of them. So this is the first, second, this one is the third, so to over here. And I think we need to use some more TNT. How much do we have left? 8, that's good. Ah, gravel. Preventing me from using TNT. Alright. So this one is the last one to over here, and then we can extend this to there, okay. And these just go down here a bit, and then go up again. Actually, good way to, ugh, dang it. Good way to collect a coal now, I have to get rid of it anyway. And I think, yeah, this is the last one, so that's fine. Let me light this up a bit. Now we just have to place our stuff, I guess. The first one is done. I know the second one, like, every step needs to be, needs to have one more repeater, so sort of like that. I have to make sure at one point that the cable is not long enough, that the cable is not too short. So this one is fine, obviously, but 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, this one's good too. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. That works. Just so I don't get a dead signal at the end. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So it's getting shorter here already, but we still have how many? This one. Oops, maybe it's gonna be enough. This one is fine. And then here, this is the longest one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Nice. That actually fits perfectly. Do I need more? Oh, wow. It turned out pretty good. So I still need... Well, I probably need more. But I still need to figure out the length of it. But we can try this by triggering the things here. So this one is fine. Just gonna have, I'm pretty sure just make, oh, I still have some. Let's use more. Let's just try those. So if I do this, this one goes off. Oh, right. I'm not connecting the signal yet to reset everything. That's the thing, because I have to reset this, and this signal has to come after everything got resetted, so this is going to be a bit tricky. I'm going to connect this with the wire down there first. All right, I actually made buttons now, so this one is going to be here to reset everything, and if I press something here, as you can see on this torch, it resets everything first, but this one is too slow. So now we have to start adding delays here. And I think it's just one. Let's try this. Oops, that was reset. Oh, no, it's still too short. Well, I guess we don't really have to do it as fast as possible. We're just going to use the last one. So yeah, this works. So every time I click, it resets and then it sets the torch. So all I have to do now, I think, is set those to 4. And it should work. All right, another test. Let's reset everything. Number 1 works. 2 works. Yep. Looks good. Oops. Yes, nice. So this works. One problem, as you can see here now, is we are sort of too close. The track needs to be at least here, so. And also this thing does not really align with this now. So I will have to come up with something else. Yeah, I can't really make this cable longer, otherwise this length thing doesn't work anymore, I think. If I add a repeater, it would always be starting from here again, no matter which button I press. So I think I actually have to move this station a bit, and it should not be too much work. The one issue is that I have to come by here, so this is going to be the first track. Oops. Right here. And it has to come from this side. Otherwise, it's not going to work. Because we have to go this way and then do this, sort of. Yeah, so it resets everything. We would just keep going. And then the first time we click this, we come down this way. So we could probably do something like that and come from here somehow. But it doesn't look good because of this stuff. We'll go this way. Nose! This is bad. Well, it's sort of working now, but it's not in a good place. I didn't expect this here. Probably should have thought about this earlier, but I'm going to move this wall over to here. So we stand this way, click a button, and the tracks are going to be this way and behind this wall, so you don't actually see it. And we can keep this and just come around this corner and swoop that way. So that should work. I'm gonna do this off camera. Just want to show you how I want to do it. Now you know. And I can probably add signs here. And maybe I'm actually gonna use colored wool for the buttons here. And then color the station so I know which one belongs to which. But yeah, I'm gonna do this next time and clean up everything off camera. So thanks for watching. See you guys next time. Bye bye.